Hey guys, it's Professor Dave, and I want to tell you some things about addition on conjugated polyunsaturated systems.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
So if we consider a fully saturated hydrocarbon to be one with maximum hydrogen content, then any pi bond is going to be a degree of unsaturation, because if carbons have additional bonds between them, then they cannot be bound to as many hydrogens as they could. So any pi bond is a degree of unsaturation, so a polyunsaturated system is a system with multiple pi bonds. Now furthermore, if it is a conjugated polyunsaturated system, that means that those are arranged in alternating single, double, single, format. So that is what allows for resonance. So a conjugated polyunsaturated system is sort of a special system. Now, let's go back to the addition reactions and see what is going to change here due to this the conjugated polyunsaturated quality of this molecule. So we're going to use a little bit of a simplified situation by looking at a symmetrical molecule. So this would be a little more complicated if there was, say, another carbon atom or something like that. But because this is symmetrical, that means that it's not going to matter which pi bond we use in the reaction. So we're just going to see what happens using one of them. So let's go ahead and do this hydrohalogenation. Let's say this pi bond is going to act nucleophilically, grab this proton, so we're going to get a carbocation intermediate. Now, because these are both secondary carbons, we would expect no preference or no regiospecificity in where that carbocation ends up on the intermediate. But if we take a look at the intermediate, we have to realize this, something here. It's exclusively going to go to this carbon because this is the position that will be resonance stabilized by the other pi bond. So resonance stabilization is something that's going to bring the energy of the system down, so that is going to be preferred. So whereas this position is not resonance stabilized because this pi electron density is just too far away to interact, this will be, and so it is exclusively going to go there. Now, what we have to realize is that there is another resonance structure here if we can move that pi bond and put the carbocation over there. And so if we look at the composite resonance structure, we see that what's going on is we have delocalized the formal positive charge. And so there is a delocalized positive charge and partial pi electron density all about this portion of the molecule. So here's where things get different, because if we have delocalized the site of electrophilicity, then we must necessarily have delocalized the point of nucleophilic attack. So remember that neither of these resonance structures actually exist, right? These are ways that we describe molecules so that we can draw mechanisms and have them make sense. But the composite resonance structure is what truly exists. So as a bromide approaches this system, it is not necessarily going to have a specific preference for this carbon over this carbon. It can either approach this carbon, pushing the electron density back over to this side, or it can approach here and push the electron density back over to that side. So what has to happen is that we need to draw another step in the mechanism, starting from each of these resonance structures, to get all of the possible products. So let's say that the bromide attacks this resonance structure, and the bromide goes there, we're going to get a racemic mixture of compounds with the bromine at that position on the molecule. But just because this is an equally valid resonance structure, we can have the bromide attack here and likewise get a racemic mixture of compounds with the bromine at that position on the molecule. So what we need to understand is that because of the resonance stabilization here, we are creating the possibility for a much larger number of products in the product mixture. And this would only be much more so the case if this were not a symmetrical molecule, because then we would have to go through this again with utilizing the other pi bond as the nucleophile. So we would have quite a greater number of products in the product mixture. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me with questions, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.